In this video, we're going to learn how to organize thoughts and break down concepts using mind maps and Lucidspark. Along the way, we'll also highlight some tips and tricks that we can use to speed up the mapping process. Let's get started. To add a mind map to the canvas, we'll navigate to the toolbar, find the organizer drawer, and then click Mind Map. If you ever forget, just remember that mind maps are a method to help us organize and break down ideas. So we're going to find them in the organizer drawer. Once we've clicked on the canvas, Lucidspark will provide us with our basic structure. Although there's a lot of different mind mapping techniques out there, most will follow this format. In the center, we'll place our main subject. Branching away from this, we'll place associated topics. Then we'll continue to expand on our topics with subtopics until we've effectively broken down our main subject. I promise, it's a lot easier to do than it sounds, so let's just jump in and give it a try. We'll start by creating a new mind map in Lucidspark. Remember, it's found in the organizer drawer. Then we'll place our main idea in the center. For this example, we're going to break down the basic food groups. So we'll click once to select our text box and then begin typing. Next, we need to identify topics associated with our basic food groups. So we'll ask ourselves, what are the basic food groups? Well, we have fruits, vegetables, grains, proteins, and dairy. Now, if we need to create additional topics or subtopics, we could just click here, but there's an even faster way. To create an associated topic, we'll press the return key and enter our text. To branch away from a topic with a subtopic, we'll press the tab key and enter our text. We can also use the arrow keys to move around across our different topics. So now that we're able to navigate a bit quicker, let's finish up our mind map by creating our subtopics. Once again, we'll start by asking ourselves a question. What are some different types of proteins? Well, we have meat, fish, eggs, beans, and nuts. We could continue to expand on these subtopics until they're no longer able to be broken down, but for the sake of this example, we're going to stop here. Returning to our other food groups, we'll continue to ask questions that help us identify subtopics and then add them to our mind map like we did with proteins. And if we ever feel like we're starting to slow down, we can leverage Lucidspark's collaborative AI to keep us moving forward. For example, we can select our dairy topic, navigate to the collaborative AI button, and then select Expand with Ideas. Within seconds, Lucidspark will generate subtopics for us, helping break down dairy even faster than my stomach can. Okay, so now we're able to see the big picture. We have an idea that's broken down into topics that are broken down into subtopics. But sometimes having a lot of branches can make a mind map feel overwhelming. So let's take a look at how we can leverage Lucidspark's mind map features to better organize and visualize our thoughts. The first feature is automatic, so that's an instant win. Whenever we create a topic, Lucidspark will assign a colored line to that relationship. So if we look at our main idea and follow this colored line, we can see that food groups leads to proteins, which leads to meat, fish, and so on. This is incredibly helpful for smaller mind maps, but if we're working with larger mind maps, lines and colors can start to feel pretty chaotic pretty fast. That's where the second feature comes in. Wouldn't it be great if we could hide certain branches so that only the ones that we want to focus on were actually visible? Well, we can. By navigating to the branch we want to hide, we can click on the minimize button to shrink it down. This helps us simplify our mind map without losing any important information, allowing us to quickly zero in on what's most important. And if we ever need to view our other branches that we've minimized, all we need to do is click on this button to make the branches reappear. Now, in certain scenarios, we may also want our topics and subtopics to appear in a specific order. For instance, if we were using a mind map to set a team goal, we'd place our goal in the center with different projects as our topics and tasks as our subtopics. We could then visualize our priorities by placing projects and tasks in their respective order of importance. We'd move the most important items to the top and move our least important items to the bottom. To move a project or task, we'll click and drag until a silhouette appears. This silhouette helps us visualize where our branch will be placed. When we're happy with our result, we'll release the mouse and our project or task will appear in a new location. Organizing goals, projects, and tasks in this way elevates the typical mind map into a powerful project planning tool. With mind maps and Lucidspark, organizing ideas and breaking down concepts is a breeze. If you're interested in learning other ways that Lucidspark can help improve your workflows, click the link and visit us at Lucid Training Labs. Happy mind mapping!